Diane, you had some other projects and things that you worked with him on. I would like you.
We never had projects that way in that sense. He was the most loyal person I've known in my life. From the day I met him, the first words out of his mouth after we saw the test, we were in this little room, and I said to myself, humor means a lot to me in my life. I'm a serious person, so anyone who wants to be funny, because it's fun, it's wonderful. Robert was that. He made light. He brought you out of a doldrum. He hated complaining. You don't call Robert and complain about your life, otherwise it's over. So the loyalty was there, and the first things he said to me, whispered in my ear, watching the test in black and white for this Fox contract, he said, your voice is so high the dogs could hear it. And it was true. And so I thought, this is a person that I can be friends with all the rest of my life. But he was loyal every year. Carol knows this. Now, every year, every time he came to LA, he would call and say, I'm rounding up the group. And he had dinner. I would usually have it at my house, or we'd go to a restaurant at somewhere. It was Carol, Cook, and a handful of three, four people. And I was able to bring some of my friends, students, and teachers to meet him at various times because they love movies too. And he was so gracious, so wonderful. And the best thing was in San Francisco when you were there, and we all had dinner. And Robert agreed to come to the academy where I was teaching, and he interviewed Anvie Coates on our stage. He said, I want to interview. Would you mind if I came in? And I said, Robert, this is fantastic. So he came over and he interviewed her and got to meet all these young people. So I want to thank you, Randy, because it's so important that the young people know Robert Osborne. So we owe it to them to give them a spirit, a beautiful spirit of thoughtfulness, of kindness, of love. Everything anyone's saying here tonight is true, and more so. So in the truest sense, we owe it to him to carry on this. And it's not just about his passion for movies. It's about the kindness and the love that he exuded, the quality and the, I can't say that when he walked in, you felt a presence. It exuded interest in other people. He never was self-aggrandizing or any kind of thing like that. It was always, how are you doing? What are you doing? Tell me about the job. I even asked him, what should I ask for a salary? I mean, it was that far. What should I do with this idea of teaching? What's a salary going to be? And he said, well, if you have to love it, you have to want to do it, you have to be passionate. So for all of the young people here tonight that I hope will stay for the film, it's a treasure, and it was his favorite. One of his favorites.